something that you... Because what you have done now is exposed some part of yourself. Revealed some part of yourself that your neighbor would not have known had you not told them. You see, the essence of community is transparency and vulnerability. Let me say it again. The essence of community. How are we going to keep our people safe?
Right.
How are we going to take care of one another? How are we going to care for our young people? It's going to require transparency and vulnerability. And you cannot be transparent and you cannot be vulnerable in the absence of trust. And if you're like me, your trust issues have been severely damaged at times in your life. And you have to want to trust again. And I cannot make you any promises today and say to you that people will not hurt you again. I can't promise you that. But I can say to you that you'll hurt more not trusting than you will trusting. What will the absence of trust do to you? It will build up in you cynicism to the point at which it'll turn into illness. It will affect your heart. It'll affect your endocrine system. It'll affect your blood pressure, because your ability to heal has everything to do with endorphins. Come on, I know I'm telling you. Somebody said, well, where'd you get that in the Word of God? I got it from the Word of God. Anybody understand me? And when your endorphins are affected and they give out negative symbols to your body, your immune system can't do what it's supposed to do, and stuff will attack you. You are what you think. You gotta hear me today. And if you'll dare to trust again, what will happen is you'll open your heart and your life up to the sweetness of what God intends to bring you. Because God's got something sweet for you. Tell your neighbor, something sweet is on the way. Now listen to this. What can we do then? Because I said something sweet is on the way. Hallelujah. God can deliver you from cynicism and the absence of trust. Some said, I'm guarding my heart. Where's your faith? I'm guarding my heart. Where's your faith? God wants your heart. Oh, you didn't hear me. And God will do better with it than you will ever do on your own. What is the role of the church then? How can we be community? Take a minute. I'm going to tell you again something that Ajamu said to me when Pastor Ann and Evangelist Linda gave him a full drum set. You know, Ajamu has a full drum set with a hi-hat and a snare and a bass drum.
Bless you now. Bless you.
Tom. They put it together and left it at our house.
No.
With the sticks. He lost the sticks. Uh-oh. And his auntie Tawana came from Atlanta. Excuse me, from New York. And gave him a whole new set.
Oh my God.
Then he found the other ones. Now he has two sets of drumsticks. And when he was playing his drums, he beat the drums and sang. Beat the drums and sing. Beat the drums and sing. And you know when he sang, he got all serious in the face. He sang all night, all day. Angels watching over me, my Lord. Kick, bang, pow! Kick, bang, pow! And then he looked around the room and he looked for his Nana and his grandma. His mother was not there. But his Nana and his grandma. And he said, Grandma! Nana, he said, come here! I got to play the drums for somebody. And he crinkled his forehead up just like this. For somebody. And he said, remember? And then he had us to sit down. Gave me a stick, he took a stick, and he told his Nana to sing and clap her hands. He hit the drum, I hit the drum, she sang and clapped her hands. And all three of us were together, and he was bang, bang, pow, bang, bang, pow, and all three of us singing. Oh, oh, then after we got through with that, we moved on to Itsy Bitsy Spider. Now came the rain. And we have a whole rep with Claus. Twinkle, twinkle. And we did the same thing for an enormous period of time, but the baby taught me a lesson.
Yes. All right, there, Chef.
What good is the ability to play drums?
Yes.
Come out here.
If you don't have anybody to play the drums with and play the drums for, here's what I want you to hear. What is the benefit of what you've been through?
Yes. Come on, Bishop.
Come on.
If it is not enabling you to share your life, come on with me now, and your experiences with some other people. Anybody understand me? The scripture says, he or she that desireth friends must first show him or herself friendly. People say, well, I want people in my life. I need you. Well,
all right.
If you want friends, real friends, tell your neighbor you got to get friendly. Oh, which means you have to be vulnerable and transparent. Nothing more has happened to you than has happened to the rest of us. Whatever it is you've been through, I promise you, somebody around here can match it tit for tat. No matter what you have suffered, no matter what you have lost, there is somebody around here who has also lost. But you choose what you're going to do with your pain. Don't let your pain choose what you're going to do with it. I'm almost there. Other thing that my baby did when he was little coming along, when I'd be asleep, and he would still be awake, and he still does this to us. When he wants you to pay attention to him,
yeah, Lord.
And you act like you're going to sleep,
okay.
He takes his fingers and he opens your prize. And then he gives you a job. Opens your eyes and he'll say, Grandma, here's what he had me doing last night. Take this string and put it around my finger. No purpose in it particularly, but it just engaged me. It got me involved with him and what he was doing. Then he said, now take it off. Now put it back on, brother. Now take it off. And then what he does is, Nana, he gets right in her face and she's sleeping in her chair. Nana! It's called loud whispering.
Right. Nana!
Are you asleep? What is he saying? He's saying, pay attention.
Yes, yes.
Tell your neighbor, pay attention.
Yes.
See me. Yes. Look at him for a minute. It's hard to look at somebody. Look him in the eyes and watch and see how hard it is to do it. It's embarrassing, isn't it? Don't you want to avert your eyes? You want to look off, don't you? Because you don't want to see too much of them and you don't want them to see too much of you. I just came to church. I'm not trying to do all that. I'm not trying to get in all of that. I'm not trying to have people all up in my business, my mix. Pay attention. Pay attention to me. Pay attention to what I'm saying by what I'm not saying. Pay attention to what I'm saying by what I can't say.
Yes.
Pay attention because my actions speak louder than my words. See me. Some of what seems to be obnoxious behavior by some of us is simply somebody asking you to pay attention. When I don't pay attention to my grandsons, they do something to make me stop what I'm doing. And if it's nothing more than negative attention, if you don't put that down, how many times am I going to have to tell you to put that? Put it down. I know you got it. I can hear you. Do not make me come in there. That's attention. Pay attention. Pay attention. Let people finish their whole sentence before you talk. Pay attention. Let somebody else say something sometime. Pay attention. Let somebody else win the argument. Pay attention. Don't need to be right. Just don't need to be. Because you don't have to the last word. Pay attention! Because people are trying to tell you something by their actions. And finally this. When we go through a difficult place and we are walking along and a loud noise happens or something, my grandsons, they spent the night with me last night, both of them. And I know that when they're moving along in life, they'll reach out and they'll grab my hand when we're walking down the street. And Jaden is up here now. He's 9, but he's gonna be really, really long. He's gonna be really, really, look at his magnificently large feet too. Big old boy. And he'll still do it. Reach out and grab your hand. And what they're saying when they say that is that I'm gonna go through this scary place with you. But I'm not going through it by myself.
All right.
You can say that to your neighbor. You're not by yourself. You're not by yourself. You're not by yourself. Now we got some scary places that we have yet to go through. We're not done. We got a few scary things. We still got to show up for some scary stuff. There's some ignorant things happening in our country right now.
Yes, it is.
And now people, they're setting fire to themselves. And driving cars up the front stairs of the White House. And there's some interesting things going on because people can feel the shift. There's a shift in the atmosphere. Things are never going to be like they were. It's a kind of scary season for some people, but that's what we're for. You reach out and you touch somebody's hand and you get connected with somebody. And it's what my children are saying is, it's a scary place. I'm not saying that I'm going to back up. But I'm telling you now, you got to hold my hand and see me through this. One more affirmation to your neighbor. Tell them, don't die alone. Playing like you're strong. Don't die alone. Playing like you're strong. Acting like you're strong. Pretending like you're strong. Don't die by yourself. Don't suffer needlessly.